Hey Dills, welcome back. We have this Ruko here in the voice. To voice him up a weird way because he doesn't go clockwise. He has the big cam on the back there, so let's put him in like this. And this little fella gave me no end of trouble the other night. I spent 2 hours trying to get him open, and the feedback from him was very strange indeed. Yeah. So I think I have a theory as to why that might be. So let's see if he'll cooperate today. Okay, I'm locked up. We go counterclockwise. So there's a short hook from the practice key. And one, nothing, two. Need to be wary of the fault set with this one. Very hard to get it off. Two, three, four. Okay, that feels like I've overset something already. Click, yes, yes. Going into that bit of a false set there now, so I'll click off 5 and 4 at a time. So 1 feels okay, 2 feels okay, 3 is on the deck. Okay, it's gonna move it. There you go, got it. 4 now is on the deck. Count, there we go. I need the counter tape, got him moving. Now, I think we're actually up pretty much there now. Yeah, maybe a 5 on there too, so. Okay, now. And get our snake right piercing in 15,000ths. Okay, now come on, maybe go for it. The one you want to go. Yeah. Come on, come on. Oh, you need it. I think you have to get multiple pins simultaneously to get this guy to open. And there we go, awesome. We have them there, so they use the old snake to just nudge them over the line. You know, not bad, 215, get the guy out of here. Yep. Don't need that no more. Let's get this fella back up here. Okay, so should be open. Here we go. See? Get this tension wedged in there. Okay, yeah, we can lock this back up. We do have a key. So, yes, let's do that. And let's put our clip thingy in here. And I'm gonna get this fella gutted. Yeah, the right tool there. Yeah, it's unfortunate you can't take that cam off because it acts like a spacer. I'm gonna have to cut it down or something. I'll get a washer. It's equally thick. There's the limiter on the back. The copper washer, you can have it set to do 90 degrees clockwise or counterclockwise. And put that there, to the side there of this fella. Okay, yeah, shim, I think there's an order for this guy too. Okay, there's a shim here. So now that's off. You see, goes clockwise, no problem. And that's the way actually Ocean had it set up, you know, clockwise, and I switched it around so it could get it in the voice of that. I don't know why I shouldn't have done that. I could have just put it in the other end of the voice. But see, there's a definite snags a bit clockwise, no problem. a bit of snag, and he wants to go counterclockwise, but that's why we picked him, so put him there. Let me just try to get this shim in. Yeah, I don't know if you can see it there. You see the copper jacket on the inside? Or the brass jacket, whatever it's made of. That was helps them get that awesome counter milling on this car. So I think we should be okay there. Right, go for a putt. Oh, that's stiff. Yeah, come on, come on. There we go. Now stay there for 1 second. Whoops. Let me just put this down momentarily and do this. Now that's better. Now there's this car, and I think that's maybe why the key pins just in that middle one, maybe the three tiny bit short, five as well. Actually, he was a tiny bit short, so he'd go counterclockwise, no problem, but he had a bit of trouble going counterclockwise. So I think that's why I was having trouble picking it too. They just couldn't get the both of them pass here at the same time. And it was some of these ones in the back, so I managed to get out with this snake rake once I got them near the shear line. Okay, yeah, let's dump these fellas out up here. That's the car off that newer Assa Euro. So, one, two, three, four, there's a key pin off the Euro I just done. Nice, there's the one of the key pins off the old 500. I think that's a 500, that's a model 600, I do believe. Sure, Henrik will correct me on that one if I'm wrong. Nicely beveled at the top there, though, every one of them. Certainly makes it trickier to get those pins to sit. So, and then also, should be able to get a good view of the counter milling in this. Hopefully the light over there. Oh, come on, come on, light. Yeah, maybe not. excuse me. I don't know if you can see it there, but use a pick. See the top of that, he just vanishes in there, and he is stuck. Look at that countermelon. This countermelon is strong in this one. Every chamber, every single one. And I tell you, it really grabs onto the edge and the edges in those pins really, really well. You put like a whole jacket around the car, and maybe the top is flattened off, and then they just wrap the jacket down there. That would help you get that effect, I suppose. So I put that over here. Get these drivers out. It's not babbling. Right. Itchy throat. Okay. Pin one. New style barreled spool. New style, that's a pin, and five, same, there we go, there's all them, and there's the springs in the car, in the body. So, we get these organized a wee bit. So here's the old car on top, the newer one on the bottom. Guess this one was made when they had none of the gin bottle spills left. When they have the gin bottle spills in them, they're really tough to pick. Let me try and get this up to the camera here without causing a catastrophe. So you can see those key pins very nicely beveled off at the top, and we have the balanced out stack there with the ASA or the new style ASA pins. And the only difference, counter milling in this car and it treads in this one. You can see the treads in that. It's much harder to see the counter milling on camera because it's just a big dark shadow. Anyway, see you next time, fellas. Have a good night.